Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. So the third week of January, I feel like I have spent quite a bit of money. I'm not sure as to how much because I haven't tilted it as of yet, but there were a few outings, so I do feel like I have spent a good amount of money, and even in categories that I wasn't expecting to spend money in, but I did have the funds available for those categories. Let's get into writing out my weekly expense for week three. The first expense of the week was at Marks & Spencer's. That was on the 17th of January. I spent £3.85 here, and this was in London where, you know, we needed water bottles, croissants, as we were a bit peckish. So this will come out of the dining out envelope. I didn't use the groceries for this because this was a day out and I was getting food while it says out and about. Categories food. The second expense of the day was at Camden and I spent £15.50. And we went to the Camden Market. So £15.50 was spent there. I feel like the food is getting quite pricey in Camden as well. I do remember back, I think a few years ago, it used to be cheaper, but I suppose with all the expenses getting high, their cost is getting high as well. It's also, just to be transparent, all the expenses I made on the 17th were on my card, because all of these, like in Camden, they weren't really accepting cash, and I just thought it would be easier just to pay everything on my card than use any cash on that day. Also spent £18.40 on train tickets. Transport. Also, I do feel like the train ticket prices have gone up even more higher compared to usual, so I think days out in London, I will probably need to allocate a bit more money towards the fund if I do decide to go out to London every month. The second spend of the week was on the 19th of January, and I spent £6.50 on a takeaway. This was a impulse sort of purchase. I wasn't expecting. I don't try and get takeaways during the weekdays. I just try and leave that for the weekend, especially for a Sunday. But I, for whatever reason, I was hungry that day and I couldn't be bothered to make myself food. And I was like, I'm going to just get a takeaway instead. So I spent £6.50 on a takeaway. This is for me and my sister. So we just got something small. It wasn't that expensive, which is good. And then on the 22nd... this day has a lot of expenses. I spent £10 in body care. So I had still some bits I needed to get, even though I said I don't need to spend any more in the personal care category. But I ran out of a few things and I didn't really plan for it properly. But luckily I did have some funds available, which is great. I also spent £79 in laser clinic for my hydrofacial. This was sort of pre-booked and I knew this was going to happen, and this payment was also made by a card as well. This is treatments. I didn't take cash out for this category because I knew I was going to pay by card, so that's fine. And then I spent £2.70 on parking. I wasn't sure how long I was going to spend in the parking, so I just did it for the whole day and that totaled to £2.70. And then I went to Farm Foods on that day and I spent £3.29. I wasn't planning to go to Farm Foods, but I just decided to go in there and there was like a few cake bars and biscuits that I wanted, so I was like, I'm just gonna get it. And the total spend for that week is, let's total it up, is £139. £24, which I don't think it's a bad expense rate. I think it's all right. I did have a few expenses this week, and it was kind of expected. I did budget for all these expenses as I knew it was going to happen. I didn't go to the cinema as planned, so that money will potentially be left over for my sinking funds. I do have an unplanned expense potentially coming up. I've got a doctor/nurse's appointment. I've just got a rash on my hand at the moment, and well, not my hand, I would say it's like my pinky finger, and that's got a bit of a rash, and it's been there for over 2 weeks, and I was just like, I need to speak to the doctor or nurse just to see what's causing it, and just probably get a cream for it. And I know, because I do work full time, I do have to pay for my prescriptions. I don't know how much they cost now, but I will have to pay for that. And because I didn't put any unbudgeted planned expenses, I don't have money for this category. So what I probably need to use is probably money from my vitamin funds, and some cash potentially either from my personal care or my cinema fund. I'm not 100% how I'm going to do it, but I'll find out next week when my appointment is, and when I get the prescription, how much it's going to cost and where I decide to actually use the funds from. Also, just to make you guys aware, for parking, I also did pay for this through card, so any leftover money is in my bank account. So if I do decide to get another park somewhere, I've got remaining amount is £2.30 on that, and also for trains, the remaining amount I've got left for that fund is £1.60, which I don't think I'll be using because I'm not going to London again this month. So that will stay in my bank account, and when it comes towards the end of the month, I'll just take that cash out. Same with parking. If I decide not to pay for parking or go out anywhere, I won't have to use that £2.30, and that'll be left in my bank, and I'll take it out towards the end of the month. The first cash envelope that I'm going to take a look at is my groceries. I wasn't expecting to spend any more money in this, but it looks like I will. I have spent. I've got £20, £30, £35. I'm hoping that I don't spend the £30. I'm potentially spend another £5 if I want to do any snack runs. I'm hoping I don't, but we'll see. I don't want to jinx myself and be like, oh, I'm not going to do any more spending, and then it turns out that I do go and spend some money. For dining out, I have 20, 40, 50 pounds left over, which I think is a good amount. We didn't spend that much in Camden. We don't weren't that hungry as expected, and the food was quite filling. So I don't really see myself spending the rest of this £50, as I don't have any planned outings for next week, the last week of January. Can't believe it's going so quick. And takeaways. I've also left a change in here just in case I decide to use this change for any more takeaways. But we'll see as well whether that happens. So I've got £10, £20, £23.50 left, which I think is a good amount. I probably will potentially get a takeaway next weekend for the whole family, so probably will use either the whole £20 or just a £10, but we'll see. But I think this is a good amount left over. Usually I do tend to have quite a lot of takeaways, so I am curbing that, so I only have one or two takeaways on the weekends. And then personal care. I wasn't expecting to spend any more money in this, but I think what happened was that I just started to run out of items I needed, so good I had funds available. So the money I've got left over is £10, £20, and again, this is a good amount. I don't really see myself spending any more in this category. I don't have any, I'm not planning to go into town to get anything, so I don't really see myself spending this money. And that's about it. I would say that's all my expenses for the week, and that's all my cash envelopes where I've spent money, and that's the leftover money left over. If you have enjoyed this video, please do subscribe to my channel. Please, if you like the video, please click on the like button. And if you also want to follow me on Instagram, you can follow me at Saadia's Finances, and then I do a few posts there on a weekly basis. I do need to do some more like live stories and stuff, but it's just finding the time. But hopefully you can join me on both Instagram and YouTube for more content on a weekly basis. Thank you. Bye bye.